Now let us go back to the error. When we try to insert the actual data, they have to be stored somewhere, right? Yes, they will be stored in a group of blocks which are called as segments. But where will they be created? In the table space where this table resides. How do we find the table space? Use this SQL. This SQL will tell where the table resides. Select owner table underscore name tablespace underscore name from DBA underscore tables where owner equals to test and table underscore name equals to example 1. How? When I created the table, I do not remember mentioning a tablespace. In fact, this is my create table statement. Create table example 1 ID number. What happens is when a user doesn't specify a tablespace name during a table's creation, then the table gets created in that user's default tablespace. How do I find the user's default tablespace? I can use the following SQL to find test user's default tablespace. Select username default underscore tablespace from DBA underscore users where username equals to test. It shows the user's default tablespace is user's tablespace. But wait, when I created the user test, I did not specify its default tablespace. See the create user statement. Create user test identified by test 567. So, how did it get the tablespace users as its default tablespace? Answer is check the database properties. The following SQL will let us know that the user's tablespace will be the default permanent tablespace if we do not specify a tablespace name during a user creation. Select star from database underscore properties where property underscore name equals to default permanent tablespace. And we can fix the problem by granting privilege on the user's tablespace to the test user. Thank you for watching this video.